Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm a bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
In for a truly marvelous dining experience. And I'm here with the bartender, and he's also a wine expert here at Jediah Hawkins in this beautiful boutique hotel. It's rich in history. It was once owned by Captain Jediah Hawkins, who founded this beautiful establishment. And I'm here with the bartender. Introduce yourself to the camera, darling.
Colin Keeler.
Colin Keeler.
Yes.
Now, Colin, tell my audience all this that we're eating. We're sitting here dining, having a truly wonderful lunch, dinner. What would be the appropriate wine to drink with this? All of this that we're eating here this afternoon?
Well, you do have a sort of a mix of food, the salad, the tuna tartare, and the duck wings. So, I mean, ideally, I think you would probably go for a Pinot Noir. However, what I wanted to showcase here was a local wine, which we'll get into in a second. The reason I would go for a Pinot Noir, because it's going to have a very light body to it. As you do have a mix of different types of foods, that's why you'd get something lighter. You could also go with a rosé. Something like that would probably complement at least the tuna tartare and the salad very well. And it would be, I think, a little bold enough to go with the plum sauce for the duck wings as well.
Now, we're also having dinner here, and we're also going to be eating the stew, the fish stew. Mm-hmm. That, what would be great with that? This looks like it would be perfect for that.
The stew, I think this would go well with it, and I'll explain why. The stew has some very bold flavors in it. It does have, in addition to the lots of the seafood that's in it, has chorizo, which is a very powerful flavor to it. And that's where I think a nice bold red would go with that. The Macari is a good wine for that. The Dos Aguas specifically, it's a blend. It's a Bordeaux-style blend. Mm-hmm. There's Petit Verdot, Cabernet, Merlot. And this had also just won the 2008 Dos Aguas just won a gold medal at the New York Food and Wine Classic.
Oh, excellent.
Yep. And Macari Vineyard has just been named this week the Vineyard of the Year for New York State, which is a great, you know, award for them. They work very hard. They produce some great wines, a lot of different varietals. And so now we're actually even showcasing this wine just sort of as a congratulatory gesture to them. And so we're going to be pouring it. Normally we only have it by the bottle, and we're going to be pouring it by the glass now
Excellent. Wonderful. Well, thank you
You're so much welcome
for talking to us about the wine and everything with this wonderful meal.
I'll certainly go over your dishes with you tonight and get you some nice wines with it as well.
Oh, I can't wait. I mean, we would love to have the appropriate wine with what we're eating. And I want you to tell my audience, first of all, do you know anything about the history of this place?
Yes, I do.
Tell my audience a little bit about the history.
Well, it was Jedediah Hawkins. He built the house for his wife in 1863. So it was just at the end of the Civil War era. He was a private captain.
Very handsome, by the way. I saw the picture in the room in the main.
Me or Jedediah Hawkins?
Well, you kind of look a little like him too.
He says that. No relation whatsoever.
Yes.
However,
very handsome.
Thank you. We'll talk later.
Yeah.
We'll get you some more wine. He built the house for his wife. He was a smuggler. Local folklore goes, smuggled guns and booze in and out of Canada and back and forth to Europe. Which is why he has such a large house, I presume.
That's how he made money. He was a crook.
Exactly. You don't get a house this big with doing things on the straight and narrow.
It's an Italianate-style Victorian house.
An Italianate mansion, yes. There was one other house in the area built by the same designer. It was in Southold, which was recently restored as well by Jim Waters, who has Waters Press Vineyard, recently as in the last, decade or so. And that's, as far as I know, the only two houses on the island that were done by the designer. I don't know specifically his name, but it's the only two in that style as well, as far as I know.
Italianate.
Yep.
Gorgeous house. How many rooms?
There's 6 in rooms altogether. There's obviously many different dining areas. We have the outside, the solarium, which we're in now.
We're in this. It's wonderful. It's beautiful in the summertime.
It certainly is. The speakeasy, the two main dining rooms, and actually the barn that we have in the back, which you can't see on camera here. We're converting next year into 6 more rooms.
You should make a theater and have like a supper club.
That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
I think that would be a great idea here. Might produce more business for the inn.
It certainly would. That's a consideration.
I think you should think about it. I mean, it's going to cost money, but hey, you have to spend money to make money, right?
Most certainly.
Tell my audience, where are you located?
Where am I located now? I'm right next to you.
Yes, darling, but where is the inn located? What's the address?
In 400 South James Ford Avenue in Jamesport, New York.
And tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information? What's the website?
It's JedediahHawkinsInn.com or JHINN.com, JHN.
Beautiful. Let's toast.
Cheers. All right.
We will be back in a moment, dogs, and more interviews in the Hamptons. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses.
Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. And the Cognac. Fabulously dressed to impress. One of a kind girl.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.